Welcome to Point of Power with Reverend Andrea Earle. I'm Reverend Angelo Allen, and welcome also to November. Well, almost. We're right on the eve of November, and November, as many of you know, is Heart and Soul's anniversary month. We are celebrating our 11th year as a spiritual center. So much to be thankful for in that regard. And we have been celebrating already. We'll continue to celebrate through the month of November. We have been offering, as part of that celebration, several of Reverend Andriette's most profound and some of our favorite Point of Power messages over these past 11 years. Today is no exception, as Reverend Andriette reminds us of our divine relationship to money and abundance. So let's watch this again and remember who we are when it comes to prosperity.
Hi, I'm Reverend Andriette, and this is Point of Power. This Point of Power series has been about money and abundance, based on Iyanla Van Zandt's essay, if you will, that in her Acts of Faith, the 25th anniversary edition, it is the essay that precedes the October daily readings. And in that essay, she says that money is my own natural energy field. That would be a powerful affirmation, a powerful statement to include as we shift our consciousness towards greater access to prosperity and abundance. Money is my own natural energy field. Wow. This reminds me of Reverend Ike, who was so clear about establishing a relationship with money that makes money welcome. So it's really at the level of consciousness that we understand that our relationship with money, how abundance and prosperity shows up in our lives, is really a reflection of what we think, feel, and do when there are matters of money concerned. It establishes that the manifestation of abundance and prosperity is also the manifestation of our beliefs and our emotions and our dominant thought patterns. This is why it's so important that we pay some attention to how we think about money. What is it we say? When someone gets a bonus, or when money comes to someone, do we have criticism about it? Do we have a thought of how that's going to ruin their lives or their personality? Then what we have to know is there's only one of us here. Even though we are speaking somebody else's name and we think we're talking about someone else's circumstances, we are always talking about ourselves. So in that moment where we're criticizing and we're predicting the doom around what's going to happen now that that person has come into some money or it appears that they will, we can see that we are simply revealing what we believe. There are those who still believe that money is the root of all evil. Now, I just want to put up the sign of get thee behind me with that. Because there's nothing about that that I choose to believe. This world, especially the part of it we live in, requires money. And so to issue statements, proclamations of damnation about what's required for our trading, our sustenance, all of that. Here's the thing. Money is not in low supply. If you believe there's not enough to go around, then that's almost your way of saying, count me out. There's not enough for everyone, so don't give any to me. And then that way, the people who believe that there's enough, they can have enough. That's the antithesis of a point of power. So what we want to do immediately to claim our point of power and stand boldly in it is to believe righteously, to remember, frankly, to remember that the Creator, the divine all in all, the living one, the strong one, the source of all supply, it's never broke. It's never like, sorry, your prayer came too late. I'm all out of health and wellness. I'm all out of rent money. I'm all out of the possibility, the infinite possibility field has been closed down until further notice. It's not possible. It's never broke. It's never late. It showers abundance all the time. We can see it everywhere. Now, having said that, I'm not saying everybody is in receipt of it, but I'm making a connection to what we believe and how we fare, the degree to which we are a beacon that is like a lighthouse drawing our good to us, saying, here I am. That would have to be a point of power. To stand as a beacon, as a lighthouse, guiding your greatest good, your highest and best, directly to you. That's a point of power.